So speaking of Sue, here's a toast to my bride. You've raised two beautiful, intelligent, strong-willed, independent daughters who are now both officially off the payroll.
Oh, Travis and Cassie have come to make their marriage vows in the presence of God and of this congregation. Let us now witness their promise to each other and surround them now with our prayers, giving thanks to God for that gift of marriage and asking God's blessing upon these two so that they may be strengthened for their new life together and nurtured in their love for God. Cassie, will you have Travis to be your husband, to live together in that covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Travis, will you have Cassie to be your wife, to live together in that covenant, that promise of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends.
But at the beginning of creation, God made them from male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate.
Put on, then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassion, kindness, lowliness, meekness, and patience, forbearing one another, and, if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other. As the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony.
Travis, Cassie, this is a good night, isn't it? Good. They both said yes, just in case you wondered. Good answer. First of all, I want to say both of you look amazing. Cassie, you look beautiful. Travis, you clean up pretty nicely, by the way. Honestly, you've dressed us all up too. This is an amazing once-in-a-lifetime occasion, right? The two of you saying I do to each other. And you've dressed the part. I'm here to challenge you, to dare you, to triple dog dare you, that every day the rest of your lives you wear this. Oh, really? You're thinking maybe not? Actually, though, in some ways you will be. You know, you've dressed the part tonight. You've dressed for this very reason, to say to the other person, I love you. You are mine. I am yours. God has blessed me with you. You've dressed in that way. And what's amazing, I think it's a blueprint. And those of you in the construction biz might appreciate that, don't you? You need a good blueprint. And what you've done here from the very beginning of your marriage, you've got that blueprint right in hand. Now the trick is following that blueprint. As any construction person will tell you, you need that. And so what I challenge you with is dressing the part, being ready for what's coming ahead, which I hope is a lifetime of just amazing goodness, of not only love, but yes, happiness, and most of all, of serving each other. I like to remind people at this point why they're getting married. So I ask them, what is it about this person sitting right next to you, standing here? What is it about this person that you're saying for the rest of my life? And this is what they had to say. It's kind of fun. I think it's the blueprint here. First of all, Cassie right away said, he keeps me on my toes. It's never a dull moment. She said, here I am, this girl in construction, hanging out with the boys. And then this guy enters the picture. And she said, most of all, and this is what I love, he just understands me. Something about knowing each other and getting each other. And right away, Travis, when I asked him, he said, yeah, the understanding and support that she gives me. And ended the endless amount of love that she has given me. I take you, Travis.
I take you, Travis.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
And these things I promise you.
And these things I promise you.
I will be faithful to you.
I will be faithful to you.
And honest with you.
And honest with you.
I will respect and trust.
I will respect and trust.
Help and care for you.
Help and care for you.
I will forgive you.
I will forgive you.
As we have been forgiven.
As we have been forgiven.
I will share my life with you.
I will share my life with you.
Through the best and worst.
Through the best and worst.
Of all that is to come.
Of all that is to come.
Until death parts us.
Until death parts us.
Address, repeat after me. I take you, Cassie.
I take you, Cassie.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
And these things I promise you.
And these things I promise you.
I will be faithful to you.
I will be faithful to you.
And honest with you.
And honest with you.
I will respect and trust.
I will respect and trust.
Help and care for you.
Help and care for you.
I will forgive you.
I will forgive you.
As we have been forgiven.
As we have been forgiven.
I will share my life with you.
I will share my life with you.
Through the best and worst.
Through the best and worst.
Of all that is to come.
Of all that is to come.
Until death parts us.
Until death parts us.
I give you this ring.
Travis, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
See, I give you this ring.
Cassie, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Travis and Cassie, by their promises before God and in the presence of all of us, have joined themselves to one another as husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Amen. Thanks be to God.
It doesn't seem that long ago that I was holding a newborn in my arms, born just before Christmas, about 29 years ago. Through the years, Cassie's provided us many proud moments as parents and many challenges as well. She's gone from schoolgirl to construction worker to project manager. And now she spends her weekends with Travis, living life a quarter of a mile at a time. So speaking of Travis, he's going to be a great partner for Cassie. He works hard, he likes to have fun, and he seems to be able to handle my little drama queen when she gets way too carried away about the little things in life. So, Sue and I are delighted to have him, Reese, and Reagan as a part of our family. Here's to love, laughter, and happily ever after. As Cassie and Travis start their new life, let's raise our glasses and toast the new husband and wife.
Cassie and Travis, there are four things you must never do: lie, steal, cheat, or drink. But if you must lie, lie in the arms of the one you love. If you must steal, steal each other's hearts. If you must cheat, cheat death. And if you must drink, drink in the moments that take your breath away. I'm so happy and excited for the two of you. You are about to embark on the most exciting journey of your lives. You truly complement one another and can fill each other's gaps with ease. You met as friends, and that friendship evolved into a love that so many people rarely find these days. Love, after all, does not make the world go round. Love is what makes the ride worthwhile. I wish you nothing but the best throughout all of the years of your marriage. Now, in true Irish form, I'd like to offer the following blessing to the couple. May your joys be as bright as the morning. May your sorrows merely be shadows that fade in the sunlight of love. May you have enough success to keep you eager, enough trials to keep you strong, enough friends to give you comfort, enough failure to keep you humble, and one more thing, enough determination to make each and every day a more wonderful day than the previous day. So ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to offer the following toast. To my little sister Cassie, to her perfect new husband Travis, and to true and everlasting love. Cheers.
Travis, Cassie, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Travis, you may kiss the bride.
I knew I wouldn't forget you. Tonight.